welcome back to Showtime TT. I am super, super duper excited to bring on the show this amazing person, this voice, this talent, this energy. David Huggins is next to me. I absolutely adore David. I look up to David a lot, and I've known him for about 3 years.
That's right.
Let's say 3-4 years. 3, going on 4 years. I met David at our job.
Mm-hmm.
And he just was amazing. So I want to hear a little bit about your journey, Mr. David Huggins.
Well, journey would have been better had I had the two legs.
Had you had the two legs.
But it is what it is. Hi, yeah. Everyone. Hi, Showtime. Hi, Internet World. Everybody, whomever you are. You're with good people, as you see. And yes, like Max and House, we need the money. Mm-hmm. Yes. You know, it will come in very handy because what they're doing is a really great job. And mm-hmm. Janine, thank you so much for having me.
Of course, of course.
Where do I start? In anybody's life prior to anything like this happening, mm-hmm. life goes on. You pay no attention to anything as we usually do, you know. You wake up, you say your prayers, you eat your meals, you go about your business, you work out, work, whatever you need to do. But you never once stop to think what can happen if something would just be altered. And it's not just a little alteration. I just want to fast forward to waking up on the morning and realizing that my leg was gone. And not just my leg, but an above-the-knee amputation.
Wow.
And I guess I could say this on internet, yes, right? Yes. It's not a problem. So I looked up to the sky, looked down, first of all, realized it was gone, looked up to the sky and I said, you sort out this shit, you know, because I went back to bed. It's as simple as that. That's what I needed to tell God,
yeah.
Because I realized that it was totally out of my hands.
Right.
It was something that had become necessary because if it didn't happen, mm-hmm. I wouldn't even be here in front of the camera.
Definitely.
And I guess from my smiling face, my bubbly nature, that I certainly have a lot of life left to give.
You have so much.
And it could not have been taken away where the death certificate would have seen negligence and not that of diabetes or any of the sort.
Mm.
This is not the forum to be bitter about what took place at the general hospital, but it is a simple case of me coming forward to do something about it.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to get this point across. This is, you're probably folks probably seeing this, and we're going to talk about it in a little while, but there's a reason behind it. It's not just an event or just a gathering. We realize that anyone, trust me, anyone, there's only ward I've met people who one, sadly, was a media person, a very well-known media person. Actually, he was a video director. And for you guys behind camera would know how important a video director is.
Mm-hmm.
And he was so well-known that he worked with me when I did the Panorama finals and semifinals on camera. And he would give the instructions, you know, come on, come off.
Mm-hmm.
He woke up with his leg gone, and within 2 weeks, he's no more.
Oh, no.
And I also had the unfortunate situation of a patient that was next to me who yelled in pain, asking for assistance. And he was being told, we can't deal with you right now because we have so many things to paperwork and stuff, because that happens with the changing of guard when it comes to nursing and stuff like that. And then he just went silent. And I thought, maybe he was just exhausted from yelling. He just fell asleep, and I just saw when they just put the sheet over his head, and that was it. He was gone because he was in so much pain that, you know, God bless his soul wherever he is. I don't even know who he is.
Right.
But it made me realize, what do I do? Do I yell and scream and bawl and say, my God, look at what has happened to me, and cry victim? Or do I shout out with the blessing of the voice that I have and let everybody realize, you know what? It can happen to you. Mm-hmm. Met someone, mm-hmm. boating accident, straight into the hospital, leg is gone.
Gee.
And it seems to be the normal thing that amputation is the call of the day, easy
right.
way out.
Right.
When we can be healed, our body is designed to heal certain things. Well, when it reaches to where it is, you have no other choice but to do what you have to do. So with that aside, we want to fast forward to what I'm embarking on in a couple of days.
Yes.
And I really want to thank you for this opportunity
of
because
course.
Everybody said to me, well, you know, are you going for the prosthetic leg? I said, well, there is an allocation that the government has in play, but because of the current situation that's going on in the country where funds are not going the way they will, or at least allocations can be tended to in the facet they would like it to, or the speed they would like it to, it's not going to happen as fast as I would like it to.
Right.
I cannot give you the duration because it's eyebrow raising.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the best way to put it. So I decided, look, I'm a talented individual. I'm well known to many people, especially in the media world, and certainly in my own little world when it comes to singing. And it will be identified on the poster that I'm very well known with a lot of the big names in Trinidad and Tobago who are very, very versed in what they do.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, hey guys, I want to do a concert to raise funds for this leg.
Yeah, so tell me about Stand for Love.
Well, this is just
fundraising concerts.
Well, I'm sure you guys would notice.
Stand for Love.
If you look at the L, you'll realize what it's all about.
Isn't that clever?
Prosthetic leg, and yes. The funds that are, I can't really reach across to that poster.
Okay.
So it's up to you. I'm going to do a Vanna White for you. I don't know how well it's going to be picked up, but we're going to both do a Vanna White.
We're going to do a Vanna White.
You know what I mean? And we smile. Stand for Love. Like, okay, enough of that. Okay, so this is what it is all about. You can tell from the cast, should I take a deep breath? I usually take a deep breath when I handle a big one. So okay. Here we go. I know you were expecting that. Now you know why I'm so popular.
That's
on
why
radio.
I love it. Oh my god, hilarious.
So take a deep breath and here we go. The performers are Wendell Constantine, Wendy Shepherd, Denise Plummer, Debbie Nahus, Johan Chakori, Raymond Edwards, Three Canal, Ray Hallman, Christian Mendez, Charlene Flores, Sandra Hamilton, Marcia Miranda, Quattro Musica, Jamal Winchester, Rico the Guitar Man, Stefan Ayong, Alexander Mack, Sergio, Jodel Lutchman, and of course myself, David Huggins. And that makes up this gigantic cast that have come together for this cause that we are hoping, once it is well received, we would like to officially make an announcement that we want to do more of these concerts because nobody does anything really for disabilities.
No.
Nobody is. You know, it's just cancer, AIDS.
Mm-hmm.
Cancer, of course, is such a big thing now, and it could consume money within a heartbeat.
Mm-hmm.
But when it comes to disabilities, there are a lot of things that need to be done. I'm very happy to see that in a couple of days, there is a concert that's coming up at my own home church, at St. Teresa's, and I'm sure you know Natasha Babwa, of the Jab Malasi fame, remember, with Marshall.
Yes.
And she's put together a concert at St. Teresa's, and I was told that I'll be doing something special. I said, what do you mean, singing? They said, no, we're putting in a ramp. I said, a ramp where? They said, well, there is a ramp outside of the church, and they decided to put one up onto the altar so that parishioners with disabilities can be pushed up onto the altar. And I said to myself, you know, I'm really happy that this leg got cut off.
That is beautiful.
You know, that's the best way to look at it. Life
that
goes on.
Beautiful.
My only regret is that my blood was not cloned with lizard amphibious thing, or else the leg and other things would have grown back.
That's right.
Yeah, that's right.
Yes.
And in the fashion, and, you know, rib it for your pleasure. Yes. So, you're probably thinking this is probably the most hilarious interview you've ever gotten.
So funny.
It's the internet, come on, you know, that's what we have there. It's showtime, as you can see, everything's being shown.
Yeah.
Yes. So, you know what, I'm really happy to talk about this concept because it's the start of something big. It's the start of something new. We really believe, we as the other artists who have come forward, believe it's time to make a statement.
Mm-hmm.
And it's time to let everybody understand that we care.
Yes.
And we're not doing the show because we care for David Huggins alone.
Mm-hmm.
We care about everyone, every one of you. I saw your clip with Stacey early on.
Yes.
Who's a good little friend of mine for many, many years. And she's so joie de vivre, you know what I mean?
Yes.
You know, God,
yes.
Amazing. And never in a million years I would have ever thought that I would have ended up in the same position.
Mm.
And all of us have dreams. My dream is to walk again.
People killing people Should you turn?